a special welcome back to our subscribers. And if you're a new user and you like what you see, support us by subscribing to the channel. In today's video, we're taking a look at the Amazon Echo Show 8 second generation. Released in the summer of 2021, it's not all that different from the third generation, which just came out and which, of course, costs more money. Currently, as of Black Friday prices, this unit is $54.99 and seems to be staying at that price. Now, while this device looks very similar to the Google Nest Hub, they're different in that each works better with its own ecosystem. The Echo is made by Amazon, so if you're using Prime, Audible, Amazon Music, you like your Netflix, your Max, your Hulu, your Ring devices, then this is the device for you. If you're into YouTube and you want native streaming, then the Nest Hub by Google is the tool that you want. This second generation device features an 8-inch HD touchscreen with a dimension of 1280 by 800. Comes in at just under 3 pounds. It has two 2-inch speakers and an onboard 13 megapixel webcam. Do note, it comes in two colors, charcoal and white, but with both models, the shutter button that closes off the camera and the cable are both white. This unit is also capable of Bluetooth audio input from your Android or iPhone. Enough talk, let's see what's in the box. I purchased my product at Target only because you get a 10% discount if you use their credit card. Otherwise, it's the same price that all the other retailers. Cardboard box, no foam, cardboard, which is nice because all of this is recyclable. You get what looks like a hello and some important information. That's it. No real manual. You'll have to go online for that. You get a power cord and a wall wart. It's sort of an off-white, a light gray in color. And let's see. To unpack it, you just lift that cardboard out. 8-inch screen measured diagonally. Here you see the shutter button, which slides across to cover the camera. Volume up, volume down. That little dot there, that's a microphone. There's another microphone here. And then there's a mute button. Speakers are through the side. There's two of them. On the back, you have a port to connect your power. And then this looks like a USB slot. And at the bottom, just a little pad for it to rest on. You can buy a stand for this if you want it a little bit higher, but that's going to cost you more because that's an option. The unit sits slightly tilted back. So let's peel this off, plug it in, and see what the setup is like. Whether you go with the Amazon Echo Show or you decide to go with a Google product, in both cases, you'll need to have a cell phone or a tablet so you can download their particular app. You'll also have to sign up and get a membership. It's free, but without that membership, you can't use the features of the device. And finally, you're going to need Wi-Fi in your house. Without Wi-Fi, you won't be able to utilize the many features of this device since it relies on an internet connection. Having an active membership with Amazon, I am ready to plug in the power. Simply insert the cable, come to the front. You see the Amazon symbol, a little bit of branding. One of the first things you'll get to do is to select your language. We're going to go with English and Spanish, make it a bilingual unit. Continue.
Hello, ready for setup.
It searches through all the available Wi-Fi setups and then allows you to pick one. You'll need not only to pick it, but to give it a password. Fortunately, you can enter that information via the touchscreen keyboard. After entering the password to your Wi-Fi router, you can select Show just to make sure that you've entered it correctly, and then you hit Done. At this point, you can save your password to Amazon. There's more information about that here. Basically, it tells you that it's encrypted and kept so that if the password is needed to connect to other devices, they will do that for you. Of course, you can decide not to do that by unchecking the box and just hitting connect. But then you'll manually have to put in your router password anytime that it's needed. At this point, you have to enter your Amazon account information and password. If you haven't already gotten an account, it directs you to go to Amazon.com to secure an account. And as before, entering the information is done via the touch screen. With your account information and password entered, you hit Done. It verifies that information, then you hit Sign In. It's at this point that you'll have to use your cell phone, go onto the app, and enter the code word that they've furnished you with. Once you've entered the code into your app or computer, you'll get welcomed to the system. Now you have to agree to the terms of usage. You can read about them by clicking on the light blue lettering, or you can hit Continue. Now we confirm our time zone. I am in North America and I am on the East Coast. It'll want to confirm your address for shipping information, or you can enter a different one, or you can skip. Now it's at this point that you have to make a decision. Where's this unit going to live in? If it's going to be in the bedroom, then you select bedroom. If you're going to put it in the kitchen, the kitchen. At the moment, this one's in the studio office, but if you want, you can not enter any location and just hit skip. At this point, you have a choice of giving it a different name than the default name, so you can type in whatever you like, and then hit continue. The screensaver will display photos from the Amazon collection, or you can use your own to supplement it. Simply select here, and then hit continue. By choosing to select our own photos, we have to use the Alexa app to upload those. And we can hit install software that gets us the latest software and firmware updates. And if you're ready to do that, you just install now.
As I install the updates, this device will restart twice.
And as you heard, the device will restart twice during these software installs.
I'm back. Let's continue.
Once rebooted, you can create profiles for each family member so you can track appointments, reminders, and just keep Alexa in the know. Of course, you can always hit later. Echo Show is a feature where someone can monitor your device by live streaming. So in essence, they can see whatever this camera is pointed at. So if you're okay with a family member or a friend having that capability, then you can enable that feature. If not, then hit not now. You can always change it in your settings. And then we're all set. We hit done. And just when we thought we were all done, we have to make a decision of whether or not we want to use the Amazon Sidewalk. It's a shared network that helps devices work better. At this point, I'm just going to disable because I really don't need to share with a whole bunch of other devices. Now, even though we opted out of the Sidewalk network, we can allow our neighbors to share our network to help them with their devices. And that's not something I feel comfortable doing, so I'm going to say disable. And do we want to make this device child friendly? So if you have kids that are going to be accessing this, maybe you don't want them accessing everything that's out there. You can say yes, make this a child friendly with Amazon Kids, or no. You get a chance to try out Prime free for 30 days. It's a trial period, but of course it starts billing if you don't cancel it. So let's not take that chance and just say no thank you. Now we get the opportunity to get the most out of our Echo Show by paying $5.99 a month so we can hear music. And in tiny print, it says, no thanks. So we'll push that. And it says we're almost done, which is good because this is starting to get a little frustrating.
Device is ready.
Finally, our device boots up and we get the current time and temperature. Now, if you want to change any settings, swipe down and there's the settings button here. And there are a whole bunch of other options you can experiment with. And then when you're done, just touch the screen and it goes back. At this point, you could say something like, Alexa, what's the temperature in New York City?
Sorry, something went wrong.
Alexa.
Sorry, something went wrong.
Oh, and what went wrong? This is where the smart device doesn't really help you. Now we have to figure out what went wrong. What can we do? Well, first thing I would do is pull the plug. What does that do? Once we plug it back in, it'll allow the system to reset. Maybe that will clear up whatever little bug happened during the setup. So we plug in, allow it to restart. And just like a computer or your cell phone or tablet, it actually has a boot up routine that it has to go through, so it's not an instant on. I see it's displaying the correct time and temperature, and we'll try addressing it once again. Alexa, what time is it in New York? Alexa, what time is it in New York City? So now it seems that it can hear us, but it's gone mute. So what's our next option? Well, I'm willing to give this another chance at rebooting, seeing that we at least were able to address and it can hear us. So let's turn it over. Once again, lose power, leave it off for about 10 or 15 seconds so that residual power from the capacitors and stuff can go down, and then we'll just plug it back in and see what happens this time. We've gone through a reboot, so now let's try addressing it once again. Alexa, what is the time in New York City? It seems that our unit can hear us, but it's not reacting to us, and it's well within the Wi-Fi reach because other Wi-Fi appliances like my laptop continue working here. So this may be defective. Okay, since our third reboot didn't work, I went into my phone onto the Alexa app and played around with a few settings, and I think we have it working now. Alexa, what is the time in New York City?
In New York, it's 2:29 p.m.
Alexa, can you play some music by Chicago?
Chicago from iHeartRadio.
Alexa, set a 10-second reminder to get out of bed.
Okay, I'll create a reminder to go off in 10 seconds. By the way, when your reminder rings, you can snooze it by saying, remind me again in 15 minutes. This is a reminder. Get out of bed.
Alexa, 10-second timer.
10 seconds, starting now.
Alexa, what's the meaning of LOL?
LOL is usually defined as laughing out loud, laugh out loud.
Alexa, tell me a joke.
What's the best thing about Mondays? I don't know. Ask me on Tuesday.
Alexa, NPR News Brief.
Live from NPR News in Washington, I'm Kristen Wright.
Alexa, what are places to see in Chicago?
Tourist attractions in Chicago include the Magnificent Mile, Adler Planetarium, Shedd Aquarium.
Alexa, what's the current airfare from New York City to Chicago, Illinois?
From faircompare.com. The average price for direct flights from New York City to Chicago is $131.
Alexa, how much is bus fare in Los Angeles?
From ownyourownfuture.com. The regular bus fare in Los Angeles is $1.75 for a one-way trip.
Alexa, recipe for Western chili.
Finding some Western chili recipes. Okay, for Western chili, here's a recipe.
Alexa, when's the best time to plant tulips in South Carolina?
Tulips are best planted in South Carolina in November or December.
As you can see, this device can provide you a wealth of information. But if you want to search on the internet, Alexa, Silk Browser.
Here is Silk.
It uses the Amazon Silk Browser. As you can see, you can reach out to YouTube, but it is not native to this application, so it won't work as well as it would if you had a Google product. Now, if you want to run something like Netflix, Alexa, Netflix.
Here's Netflix.
And of course, you'll have to supply your account information to gain access to it.
This is a reminder. If you found this video interesting and useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team. It has always thank you so much.